What is that?
Thanks a lot for coming along with Life with BillSiff. Let's see what's really going on.
How you doing today? Welcome to Life with BillSiff. I'm your host, BillSiff. Today on the BillSiff Show, I'm working on the front seat on the Ezgo. Now, let me tell you a story here. As you know, I thought I got the wrong covering, so I ordered another one, and it didn't fit, so I ended up putting it on the back seats of this thing. So that looks all right. But I ordered another set for the front seat because I thought maybe it was wrong, because it was freaking tight. Like, I'm talking tight. I was looking at like 9 inches of stretch, Captain. That's a lot. Hey, if you're looking for 9 inches of stretch, that's a lot of stretch. But hey, look, I got a tomato plant coming in here. But stretch, we're talking about stretch here, and I got to cut my grass. But I know I'm all over the place. But stretch, 9 inches of stretch. So I called the company. I said, "Listen, do you mind looking up this cover for me and seeing what the hell is really going on? Because I need to know." "Oh, what are you? How you doing, bud?" So he looked it up for me and stuff like that. And it turns out that that's the right cover for the golf cart. You gotta stretch the shit out of it. So I put it in the sun, let her soak the sun up for a bit, gave it a microwave. Then I threw it in the oven for a few minutes, dipped it in some hot water and put it back in the sun again. And we got her on. But let me tell you one thing. I'm not real impressed with how it fits. I had to wrestle this thing like no tomorrow to get it over. And if you look at the seams, they're kind of stretched and they might rip down the road. But I tried to get that kink out and I just couldn't get the right pull. I'm hoping that maybe in time she'll kind of work herself out. But I got her on. It looks okay. Seams aren't straight. They're kind of all cocked over looking. Whoever sewed them up, I probably could have sewed them a little better myself. Especially that one right there. What's really going on? Should ask for a discount on that one. If you're working with these covers, let me tell you what, have some patience. Well, I'm standing right here right now. Look at that match. What happened? Like, that can't get any friggin' better of a match right there. That's looking pretty friggin' decent. But I was able to get it, put the slides on. There she is. I know you're gonna say, "How come you didn't stain that?" I just didn't, okay? I got her double stapled at all the seams to hold her together. And I got double stapled all the seams down there. Get the plastic thing back on. Put on these old ratty looking old friggin' handle grips there. You know, because that's what I do. It is what it is, you know? I tried to heat them up and make them black again, but it didn't work. So I'll just throw some armor all or something on that. If you're around my area, 303. You can get it at GoGlass Accessories. Why wouldn't you? That's how that went. So now, all I gotta do is remove this cover here, build a new piece of wood for that, and then recover that, and the seats are done. And then this thing is calling somebody's name. I don't know whose, but it's calling somebody's. Oh, I gotta screw that back down too. That's all getting cocked over. I should put a couple screws in that right now while I'm thinking about it. Hey, how come I can see right down there? What's really going on? We can put that back on soon, give her a wash job, get her alignment, straighten the rear end as much as I could. Still needs a little bit more, but we'll work on that. She's not dog tracking or anything, so I don't know, man. She's mint, as far as I'm concerned. We'll get that cover back on. This is just a short little update video on how I'm making out with the covers. Because, you know, I've had like 2-3 videos now talking about covers. You see me do the back one, though, so I don't know if you need to see me do this back one either. Just let me know in the comments. Why wouldn't you? You could own this golf cart. Leave me a message down below if you want to come pick her up. I'm open to any suggestions within reason. I'm telling you right now, if you come in less than 5,500, then 55 or 5. Leave it with me. That's Canadian, of course. So don't offer me US. I know what the US dollar goes for, so look it up before you put an offer in if it's US money, because you can easily type in how much is 5,250 Canadian and American right now, and that will tell you how much it would cost you. Remember, this thing's got a cooler, so that's worth like $20 right there. Well, no. Actually, sorry about that. The cooler was actually $48, so that's worth like $100 right there. Freaking right it is. But we gotta get this thing cleaned up once we're done. Polish the steering wheel, get some right-sized bolts for it, do this, that, and the other friggin' thing, and you all know how it works. So hopefully you're all having a good day like I am. Welcome any new subscribers to the channel if you're here. How you doing? Other than that, oh, one other thing I wanna bring up. Dennis, there that we're gonna go out on the boat on that fountain. Yeah, both engines are hooped. So he's in the process of ripping these engines down on this boat that he just paid $120,000 Canadian for. Just got hosed right over, poor guy. Hey, I should open a GoFundMe. Anyways, I feel sorry for him. So we're not going to get it right on that, but this year, maybe next year. So that's, if you're wondering what happened there, that's what's happened. I got to tell you guys, because you're my fans and you're going to ask me sooner or later, hey, what about a ride on the fountain? Well, it didn't happen. That's why. So I figured I better tell you that right now.
Right now.
If you're in Canada and you want a t-shirt, hit me up, because I love to sell you some of my t-shirts. It helps me support the channel. It helps me get a few things that I can play with on the channel for you guys and myself, of course. I'm not going to say it's not for me. I love playing with new stuff. If you want a t-shirt, hit me up. $25 Canadian will get you a t-shirt, and it'll get me whatever saying you want. I know I have a lot of American friends waiting for t-shirts. I really appreciate it. We're getting real close to that border opening now. They're talking next month, so we'll be able to get that rolling soon. So just have patience there, and we'll get you some t-shirts. And you know who you are. I still got you on my list. I do. Love y'all. Thanks for being here.
And you know what to do for now.